yoga practice this morning. You don't need anything, you just need a space which is yours. Yeah, that's it. I like to start my classes with a check-in. Those of you who've done yoga before might be used to that. It's simply where you just ask yourself the question, how do you feel before we begin? What's going on in your body? Possibly what's going on in your mind? And it's perfectly okay at the moment to be feeling all kinds of things. We've all been thrown into a slightly different normal. So I am checking in feeling sad, and I feel sad because it's probably one of the last times I can come to this studio and do some practice here. So for me, it's a real safe space, and it's a space I really like. It's where I've got used to meeting people, meeting friends, so that feels a bit sad. I'm also checking in feeling grateful. I feel grateful that I get to do this practice, and I get to practice with lots of you who I've never met before. That feels really good, and to know that there might be lots of you doing this in your own homes at the same time feels really positive. So I'm really grateful for that. So maybe just pause now and think, if we were sat in a circle and you were asked to check in, what would you be checking in with? How are you doing? How are you feeling? What's going on for you right now? And remember, you could always maybe check in with a friend and say those things to them maybe later, and allow them space and time to tell you how they feel as well. Our class today then is all about balance. It is a class that was co-constructed with three other teen yoga teachers, Sally and Joe and Natalie, who are actually in all different locations, Peru, Spain, and in the UK. And I think it shows, I wanted to do it because we had joined up thinking creating it, and I want to encourage you to do that as much as possible, connect and resolve things with friends who matter to you. So we're gonna find balance in today's class. So we're going to accept that sometimes we might feel one way, sometimes we might feel a completely opposite feeling at the same time, and it's okay to lean into both feelings. We want to try and find some kind of center within ourselves. So that's the aim. Try and enjoy it, and just see how you get on. Okay. So, you're going to start on your mat. You might not have a mat, that's absolutely fine. Just start seated. And actually, I'm going to encourage you to sit all the way down on your bottom. So if it feels good to sit cross-legged, then maybe do that. If it feels good, I want you to invite you to close your eyes. And let's simply just pause together. When we stop is sometimes when we begin to notice. Now in yoga, we try and breathe in and out of our nose. And we're going to try and do some breathing together just to maybe slow things down and transition from whatever you were doing previously into now. So just feel where your bottom meets the ground underneath you, whether that be on carpets, outside, wherever you are. I'm going to inhale however feels good for you. I'm going to exhale to prepare. And then I'm going to inhale together, 2, 3, 4. Find a natural pause, and then exhale, 2, 3, 4. Inhaling, 2, 3, 4. Find a natural pause, and exhale, 2, 3, 4.
square, inhaling down the side of the square, and exhaling down the bottom. Have a go. Okay, well done, good job everybody. You're going to come then so you're in a, stay in your seated position. Okay, you're going to inhale, I'm just going to come onto my knees because I've been a bit low. So you're going to inhale your arms all the way up. You're going to just lower your shoulders there and then you're going to fold your arms in front of you so that your right hand is coming over on top of your left hand. And you've just then made a really strong kind of equals pose. Any of you who are involved in International Women's Day earlier this month, that was their symbol, all about equality. You know, inhale your arms up, and then just exhale them all the way down. This time you're going to inhale your arms up, and just let your left arm now come and sit on top of your right arm. Again, feeling nice and strong, really balanced in front of you. And remember, we're going to try and get that equal feeling in our body. Inhale your arms up, and then just exhale your arms all the way down. We're going to start moving our body now. So I want you to drop your chin all the way down to your chest. So you're going to drop your chin all the way down to your chest. Bring your eyes up, gazing your eyes all the way to the ceiling. Dropping your chin all the way down. Lifting your eye gaze up and looking all the way to the ceiling. Coming back to your midpoint, you're going to look over your right shoulder. So looking all the way over your right shoulder. Bringing your eye gaze through the middle and then looking all the way over your left shoulder. Again, bringing your gaze to the middle, looking over your right shoulder. Midway point and then looking over your left shoulder. From there, drop your chin down and just start to give some big circles. If anywhere there's a little pinch, just stop and then continue to rotate all the way around. Particularly if you've been doing some schoolwork, really important release point. And then just change direction and circle yourself all the way around. Okay, we're going to bring our attention to our shoulders. So we're going to circle your shoulders all the way back. Really nice, and then go all the way forwards. Really feeling into your joint. This time, I want you to bring your shoulders up to your ears. I want you to feel tension, tension, tension. Anything you've been holding on to, anything that's been stressing you out, and with the exhale, just release. Find tension, 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 and then with the exhale, release. And find tension, 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 tension. One last exhale. Okay, from there, you're going to bring your arms out in front of you. So it's going to come side on here. You imagine someone is pushing towards your hands, and so your shoulder blades are going to come back together. They release, so you're just nice and normal. And now I want you to imagine you're pushing someone away from you. Your shoulder blades come back to normal, and then again, you pull them towards each other. Back to the middle. And then push them all the way away from you. Okay, great. From there, I'm going to come and face you. You're going to bring your arms out in front of you, and then you're going to find 45 degrees, so you're angling your fingers in. You're going to drop little finger, next finger, middle finger, first finger, thumb. You've made some fists. Really feel into those fists. Let the fists drop all the way down, and then let them lift all the way up. Opening thumb, first finger, middle finger, ring finger, little finger, and then flare your fingers all the way towards you. And then just shake out. Okay, we're going to do that one more time. So it's thinking about how your brain and your body is working together. So little finger, ring finger, middle finger, first finger, thumb. Let your wrists drop all the way down, almost making yourself shake a bit. Your wrists come all the way up, and then we open thumb, first finger, middle finger, ring finger, little finger, flare your fingers towards you, and then just shake out. Right, this time we're going to come over the top of your knee, and we're going to find what we call a tabletop position. So you want to be nice and square. Check, are your wrists underneath your shoulders? Have you got nice starfish hands? And then I'm just going to invite you to tap your feet on the ground if it's safe to do so. And that just releases some energy. Okay, from there, what we're going to do is we're just going to think about our lower back, and we're just going to let our tailbone creep up and then tuck under. So it's just my lower back moving. Check, my pelvis is just tilting up and down. I'm going to stop. I find my nice neutral steady position, and then I'm going to think back to my shoulder blades, and I'm going to imagine my shoulder blades coming together, and I'm pinching a pencil together. I'm then pushing into my hands that are in the floor, and I'm just rounding the top of my back, and it feels nice and open. So I bring my shoulder blades together, they pinch, and then I let them come all the way apart, and then I might just want to shake out slightly, finding my steady position. Then this time my pelvis comes backwards, my back arches, and I look all the way up with my head into my cow position. My head starts tilting in, my pelvis starts moving in, my belly button is moving towards my spine, and I'm taking a really nice cat stretch. I move my pelvis back, I start to lift my gaze up, and I arch my back into this cow. And then I move my pelvis in, tuck in, tuck in, tuck in, push into my hands to find a nice cat stretch there. Okay, from there, just find a nice neutral position. We're going to allow your hips now to come all the way back. So they're going to rest on your heels. From there, just let your eyes and your forehead drop all the way down. And we call this child's pose. Now you can take child's pose anytime you want to have a pause. From there, you're going to lift and tilt your fingertips towards your shoulders. You're going to then rock forward, your hands flatten on the floor, and you're just going to keep going over, over, over to peer over. Maybe what the next few days have in store. Allow your hips to come all the way back. Find your child's pose position, allow your fingers to come all the way up. Rocking forward, your hands find space on the floor, and you look and tilt over, so you're rocking your weight over your wrists. And then just come back to a nice neutral position. Right now, I want you to imagine you're a paintbrush, and I give your body full creative license to move in any way it wants to. So for me today, that means my ribs want to move. It means my elbows want to move a bit. It means my hips want to maybe go in a circle one way, a circle the other way. No wrong, no right. Just let your body move, come out of your head, and just let it move. Whatever way feels good, you're just going to find a moment of stillness. From here, check your hands feel nice and strong in the mat. Tuck your toes, and then imagine that someone is behind you, lifting your hips up. You're gradually going to lift your hips high in the air to find downward dog. From downward dog, we're going to walk our dog. That basically means one heel goes down, one toe comes up, and you just take it in turns. You should feel really nice stretch into each calf muscle. Just find a moment of stillness. And then you're going to walk your feet, you're going to tiptoe your feet forward. There might be space for them. And you're going to come into what we call a forward fold position. Just kind of where we're hanging. Your knees might want to be bent. You might want to bend your knees enough so you actually feel your chest come onto the tops of your thighs. From there, you're going to roll up. So starting all the way at the bottom of your spine, allow yourself to come up one vertebrae at a time. should be your head. And then if you've got a mat, come to the front of your mat. If you haven't, just come towards the front of your space. We're going to find mountain pose. So mountain pose is where your palms are forward and your feet are fully into the ground. You might just want to rock forwards and backwards. Just feel the ground underneath you. Perfect. Okay. From there, maybe see if you can close your eyes. How does that feel? Do you feel steady? If you can, keep your eyes closed. If that feels too strange, then open them. You're going to now just lean into your right leg, and you're just going to see if you can hover your left leg off the ground. Just really lean into that leg. And then you're going to bring your weight back across, so it's over both feet. Allow both feet back on the ground. Now you're going to do the opposite, so you're going to lean into your left leg, lifting your right foot off the ground. And then you're going to come back 2 feet on the ground so that you know you can lean, but you also know how to find that steadiness as well. Maybe do the same lean forward onto your tippy toes, doesn't matter if you fall. And then come back, feel both feet underneath you. And then maybe rock backwards, your toes might come up. And then again, find that nice grounded center. From there, you're going to inhale your arms all the way up. I'm just going to step back a bit so you can see. Find that nice kind of strength between your two arms. Check in, have your shoulders come up. Do you need to pull them down? It's always nice to have space between your shoulders and your ears. From there, you're going to fold your arms in front of each other. Your left hand comes down, your right hand comes on top. You find that nice strength, that idea of being equal. Arms come back up again, equal between your arms, shoulders come down, hands fold, left hand is coming up to the right arm. Bring your hands all the way up. Okay, this time our two palms are going to meet, and we're going to exhale, folding forward at the hips. So we're going to do a half sun salutation, if you know what that is. We fold forward at the hips. Inhale, halfway lift, looking towards an imaginary horizon. So where that sea and the sky meet, dropping yourself down. Inhaling your arms up high and wide. Exhaling, hands come back in front of you. And just feel your two palms, maybe allow them to push against each other. And just feel nice and centered in the middle. Inhaling, arms up. Folding forward at the hips, slowly all the way down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, drop down. Inhaling your arms up high and wide. And exhaling, hands come to heart center. We're just going to add some movement on. So we're going to inhale your arms all the way up. We're going to exhale, fold forward at the hips. Inhale, halfway lift, look towards the horizon. Dropping your hands down either side of your feet so you can bend your knees here. You're going to step your right foot all the way back, and it's like you're starting a race. Lift your chin up, lift your chest up. Drop your back knee down, untuck your toes. Inhale your arms all the way up. Pull your shoulders down. From there, finding that nice balanced position one way, right hand above left hand. Arms come up. Dropping your hands down, finding your left arm above your right arm. Arms come up. Your hands are going to find your hips like a superhero. You're going to tuck your back toe. You're going to engage your legs. That basically means switch your muscles on. And then you're going to lift up into your legs to find a lunge position. And see if you can feel like that superhero. Superhero strength. Bring your arms out in front of you so they're nice and equal. Imagine now that you are being pulled forward. So someone's got your hands and they're just gently encouraging you to pull forward, and you're actually going to put your weight into your front foot, maybe take a little step first, pushing towards the back of the room. Dropping your knees down first, lowering your chin and your chest to the floor, elbows tuck in, just come all the way onto your belly. Pushing your tops of your feet into the floor, your pelvis into the floor. Inhale, slight little lift. Tucking your toes, you're going to come through bent knees, lifting your hips to find that downward dog position. Push your heels down, how does that feel? From there, you're going to lift your right leg up and high in the air, and then you're going to step that same right leg through and forward. You're dropping your back knee, you're untucking your toes, you're coming all the way up. You're exhaling your hands down, you're stepping your back foot to meet your front foot. Pause, then inhale together, halfway lift. Drop yourself down. Inhaling your arms up high and wide. Exhale, let's just pause, palm to palm in front of your body. Doing the other side, inhaling your arms up. Exhale, fold forward at those hips and in your bottom back. Inhaling, halfway lift. Exhale, hands drop down inside of your foot, stepping your left foot back this time. Lifting your chest, looking forward, dropping your back knee down and tucking your toes, inhaling your arms all the way up. Checking with your shoulders, do you need to lower them down? Folding your right arm on top of your left arm, feel nice and strong. Arms come up. Folding your left arm on top of your right arm, feel nice and strong. Arms come up. Let's drop your hands. Let's find your superhero inner power in your hips. Tuck your back toe. Engage your legs. They've got to find feel strong before you lift up. Engage to lift up into your high lunge. Let's bring your arms all the way up. Your hands can come forward. Someone's gently putting you. Let's see if you can do it in one this time without a little step. So really transfer your weight. Focus on something in front of you. Perfect. How does that side feel compared to the other side? Dropping your back foot down, arms come up. Hands come down, stepping this time your front foot to meet your back foot, high plank. You can either do knees, chest, chin, or if it feels good today and you're feeling strong, you can try and lower down in one, keeping those elbows in. Untucking your toes. This time you can either lift a baby cobra, or we can maybe lift a bit higher, so engage the front of your feet first, push your pelvis in, lifting all the way up to upward facing dog. Bring your shoulders back. Tuck your toes, push to downward facing dog. And just pause. Inhale your left leg up into the air, stepping your left foot through and forward, dropping your back knee down, untucking your toes, inhaling your arms up. Exhaling your hands down, stepping your back foot to meet your front foot. We inhale halfway lift, we exhale all the way down, we inhale our arms up high and wide. And we exhale, finding our hands just in front of us. And this time, we're just going to open up to mountain pose. Remember that nice position, palms facing forward, maybe closing your eyes, maybe having a little sway, feeling how you're able just to correct yourself and come back to full balance. Okay, this time, you're going to have your legs quite wide apart. You're going to bring your right foot, so basically you're making an L shape with your feet. So at the moment, my left foot, my toes are kind of pointing forwards, and my right foot, they're pointing Bring your hip back. Allow your hand to be pulled forward. This is your right hand. Your right hand leads the movement as you tilt down. Maybe you want to look up at that top left hand. Allow yourself to come all the way back up again. And all we're going to do is we're just going to change sides. So this time you face your right toes forward and your left toes out to the side. And just check in with your stance. Okay, hip comes back. Left hand gets guided forward and then your left hand leads, tilting forward or to the side. Coming all the way up, not too quick. And again, just maybe just release your legs so you can go back into it again. Hip comes back, being guided by your front hand that goes forward. You're finding that nice stretch. And then you're tilting, possibly looking up at your hand. A nice inhale and exhale here. Taking up that space again. We're going to bring our feet together. We're going to keep the idea of balance. You might want to find your hands on your hips. Your weight is going to go into your right foot. Your left foot hovers. You're going to just let your toes come out to the side once. So it's the idea of your hip bone moving in your joint. Again, let your left toes track out to the side. And if it feels good, you're going to raise up. Find a point to put your left foot resting on your right supporting leg. Now, if it's coming in where your knee is, just don't push, okay? We might want to now find your hands at heart center, okay? That idea of almost pushing against each other to find more balance. I want to see, can you grow your arms all the way up into beautiful branches and find that balance? Can you pull your shoulders down? Can you lean now all the way over to your right hand side? Just let's see how far can you go. If you fall out, it doesn't matter, remember. And then allow yourself to come, whoop, come back up to the top. We're all different, we'll all manage this in different ways. Just like all trees are different. Can you lean into the right hand side? And then again, allow yourself to come back up, check in with your shoulders up, look up to your ears, just find the space. Now I want you to imagine you're in a storm, okay? So this tree is blowing all the way around. Can you maintain balance? Just showing that actually you're very resilient when we have these storms. You're gonna have your weight now in your left leg, right leg hangs down. Track your toes out to the side. So finding that rotation from this hip joint. Let your toes come out to the side. And this time again, when it feels good, allow your foot to find a resting point on your supporting leg. Finding your hands together. Use this to help you balance. Growing your branches all the way high and opening your branches. Great. From there, can you lean to the left? Over that supporting leg, just correct yourself if you come out. Can you lean over to the right, so towards that bent leg? And notice how different sides will feel different. And then you're in that storm again, so just allow yourself to kind of weather that storm before finding a nice balanced position and possibly just allowing a little bit of a shake there. In fact, a shake feels good, so maybe just really going down into your legs and shaking, feeling that connection, solid connection with the ground. Okay, from there, you're going to come to the front of your mat. You're going to make your legs kind of wide like this, because then we're going to come into a yogi squat. Okay, so at the front of your mat, allow yourself to squat down. Then you take a pause. Hands are going to come behind you, and then you're just going to find, so you have your, you're going to have your feet on the ground, so solid soles of your feet. Would you be able to stop? Can you come down? If the end of us say stop, would you be able to stop? And maybe that's something to practice. From there, then you're just going to open up, allow your feet to flop to the side, your palms to be up. You might just want to let your hips wiggle to the side. And if it feels good, just close your eyes here for a moment. We're going to just slow the body down slightly. And we're going to return to that idea of equal breathing. So if you inhale to prepare and exhale to prepare, and then together we're going to inhale 2, 3, 4, natural pause, exhale 2, 3, 4, inhaling 2, 3, 4, find a natural pause and exhale 2, 3, 4. Once more, inhaling 2, 3, 4, natural pause, exhale 2, 3, 4. Maybe just continue that for 2 more rounds by yourself. Okay, when it feels good, you're going to bend your heels, bend your knees, sorry, up, and just make sure the soles of your feet are on the floor. From there, you might want to turn your palms, they're palm down rather than palm up. You're going to tilt your pelvis so that your back flattens into the ground, and then you're going to lift your hips up slowly. So you're putting some weight through your feet, pushing into the floor, raising your hips all the way up. Take a pause, and then again, allowing your vertebrae to come down, vertebrae by vertebrae, from the top all the way down to the very bottom of your back. Maybe allowing yourself to open up to your natural curve of your back, so it should feel like a relax. Then push your back into the ground to flatten, and then allow your hips to come all the way up, lifting off the mat, vertebrae by vertebrae, coming all the way up onto the tops of your shoulders, taking a pause, and then bringing yourself back down, vertebrae by vertebrae. Okay, perfect. From there, everything should be back in contact with the mat. I'm going to invite you to lift your legs up into the air. So just taking a moment to let all that blood rush down from your feet, putting your feet up, and then maybe just allow your legs to bend, your toes are going to touch the floor, and then using your stomach muscles, lift your legs all the way up again, allowing your knees to bend, toes tap on the floor, lifting your legs all the way up in the air again. And this time just allowing them to naturally come back down to resting on the floor. From there, you're going to bring your knees in and give yourself a really big hug. So maybe lifting your forehead to your knees. You're going to bring your arms wide so they make a T shape. And then just allow your knees to drop over to your right hand side. Your back might click like mine did, that's fine. Again, allowing your knees to drop all the way to the other side. So coming through that neutral point, allowing them to drop and just gently lowering them with control. Now this time you might want to look over your opposite shoulder. You're going to bring your knees all the way up again. Give yourself a really big hug for doing your yoga practice today.
We're going to finish with a small relaxation. So you can either come into Shavasana, which is where a bit like you're lying on the beach, your feet are flopped open, your palms are facing up. Or if it feels better for you, you can roll over and just make a pillow with your arms, turn your cheek to one side maybe, and find a nice resting position on your belly. And just notice how hopefully you feel quite balanced as you're lying on the ground. Lots of things have changed in a really short amount of time. Actually, when you lie on the ground, you can feel that real steadiness underneath you. It's not moving. So that steadiness is still there. Sometimes we just have to allow ourselves to find it. So as you're lying there, I want you to imagine it's a really nice sunny day. The sun is high in the sky. The sky is so blue. And you start to feel the warmth of the sun all over your face, sinking into your skin. That warmth starts to spread from your hat, from your face, all the way down through your body, over your chest, down both hands, finding the top of your hands, bottom of your hands, warming every single finger from thumb all the way to your little finger. The sun's warmth finds your belly. It finds the tops and fronts of your thighs. It warms the bottom of your legs, the calves and your shins, the top of your foot, the sole of your foot, your big toe all the way through to your little toe. As you lie there in the sun, knowing right now nothing is needed from you. Slowly bring your mind back from wherever it wandered to, in the warmth of the sun. Maybe wiggling your fingers, wiggling your toes. Maybe stretching your arms all the way above your head, letting your feet stretch all the way below you. And I invite you to tuck up into a ball on one side before slowly coming up to a seated position. Going to bring your hands to meet, maybe closing your eyes, gently push with your left hand into your right hand, gently push with your right hand into your left hand, before simply just allowing your two palms to meet. Namaste everybody, thank you so much for practicing with me this morning. As part of this, we have challenges. So we have a well-being tip and we also have a challenge for you. So the first thing I would like to share is I would like to share my well-being tip for you. So I'm going to actually come and pick you up and I'm going to walk with you, which might be easier said than done. So my challenge for you is a creative challenge. So as part of well-being is to get creative. And so being creative is really important. For me, it helps me tap into just going with the flow. And we've all got a bit of time now to be creative. So my challenge, or not my challenge, because that's something different, but my well-being tip is to get creative in whatever way appeals to you. So my, So basically, this is your creative inspiration today, and this is a sunflower. And a sunflower links to our theme because a sunflower starts facing the east in the morning, and then throughout the day, it tracks across the sky until it faces the west. And in order to do that, basically the stem grows on one side to tilt it, and then it will gradually grow on the other side to tilt it the other way, okay? So actually during the nighttime, the sunflower really uses that to recenter itself, and I thought that was quite interesting. Also thought sunflower was interesting because we can't find sea sunflowers at the moment, but now is the time to plant sunflower seeds. And so hopefully when all this is over, the sunflowers will be growing nice and tall. And I thought that might be a nice thing for some of you to do, to actually plant some sunflowers and watch them grow. So get creative. Sunflower is your tip, is your starting point if you want it to be. And you could paint a sunflower, you could do some drawings, you could write a poem about sunflowers, you could write a story about how you come across this field of sunflowers and your adventure, you could write a song, do some kind of music. If movement is your thing, you could create a TikTok dance, you could create a yoga sequence that is all about a sunflower maybe moving or opening. Here is my creative offering. I'm just going to show you. I don't know if you can see this. So I basically used some flowers and I have created a sunflower mandala. So use the petals and the leaves and some coffee beans. That's my getting creative today. I simply like how petals feel in my hand, and I might even put them in my bath later as a bit of self-care. So that's my well-being tip. And my challenge for you today is it's really nice when people, when someone does something for you without you having to ask them to, when they simply notice what you might need at that time. So our challenge for you today is to do a chore around the house or do something that helps somebody else without being asked. And that can be in whatever way fits into your family situation right now. But rather than being asked to do something, it'd be super great today if maybe you can just do it without being asked or go above and beyond and do that little bit of something that might make it a bit easier for somebody else. Remember to share what you're doing. I would love to see your sunflower creations and what you get up to. Stay safe and hopefully see you soon for more yoga. Take care, everyone. Bye.